Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to this update for the Benbox HDMI transmitter and camera controller. Now in the previous video I was on about the fact that I could not get the app to run under Windows nor under the Mac OS systems. I finally got it to work under Windows 10. Unfortunately the whole download is in Chinese, so you just have to accept the default screens as you're going through the installation, but then you can get it to work. Now I've also discovered within the app that if you double tap the screen you can get to a clean screen. So for example, if you're recording the output on your iOS device using screen recording, you can get a clean feed onto your iOS recording. I'm going to demonstrate that now. So at the moment what you're seeing is the overlay from the app itself. So you've got the bars at the bottom for the histogram, you've got the zebra stripes, you've got black and white display and the overlay for the markers. But if I double tap the screen, you notice they disappeared. So now you've got a clean signal that you're recording on your iOS device. And it's the same with Windows. If you double click the area of the screen, you'll get a clean picture as well. So you can actually transfer that into something like OBS to do live streaming as well. Now you still can't input audio. Unfortunately with the Canon cameras I've been using, you can't take audio out. And I've also discovered that you can't take the clean HDMI without putting it into manual mode. So there's a couple of caveats around recording using the HDMI output, but I'm going to document that in a complete tutorial on my photo blog site. And I'm going to put a link to that in the video description below. Well, at least now we've got a full iOS recording facility on our iPads or iPhones, so we can actually capture the HDMI as though we were capturing it for a live stream. We still can't capture audio because that's not supported as yet. I have contacted the developer, but no response from them as yet. Neither is the response on the fact that we can't get the Mac OS 64-bit working. Hopefully that will come soon. So there we are, that's the update for this. I thought I'd just feed you back the news that there are some progress being made. The more I play with the app, the more I'm discovering the features of it and its potential for future projects. So that's it for the video. Thanks very much for watching. And of course, if you're new to the channel and you like what I'm presenting, please do click that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and that will be fantastic. So look to seeing you all. 3, 2, 1. Well, there we are. That's the update to this video. Hopefully you found that useful. If you're a new viewer and you've not already subscribed, please do click that subscribe button and click the bell notification icon to get advised when I upload new videos to the channel. Okay, that's it. Thanks very much for watching. Please do take care and I'll see you all in my next one. Goodbye for now.